Cleanse me with my soul, that I may be pure. Wash me, and I will be white of that snow.
You will have me here, gladness and joy. The bones you have crushed will rejoice.
Turn away your face from my sins. Blot out all my iniquities.
A clean heart create for me, God. Renew within me a steadfast spirit.
Do not drive me from before your face, nor take from me your Holy Spirit.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
O Lord, in your mercy, amen. Now the reading will read someone from the family.
Father, please give your blessing.
May the peace of the Lord be in your heart forever and ever.
Here is a man of integrity, whose good life will not be forgotten. His reputation will be passed on to his descendants, and this will be their inheritance. His family continues to keep the covenant and will because of what their father did. His family line will continue, and his glory will not fade. His body will be laid to rest, but his reputation will live forever. The people will proclaim his wisdom, and the assembly will celebrate his praises. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Be with you. From the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Saint Matthew, who proclaimed life to the world, let us listen to the proclamation of life and salvation for our souls.
Remain silent, O listeners. The Holy Gospel is to be proclaimed to you. Listen, give glory and thanks to the word of the living God.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord Jesus says, come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart. And you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. This is the truth. Peace be with you.
Praise and blessings, Jesus Christ.
Dear Deacon Paul, dear family of our beloved brother Bill Koury, dear friends and parishioners. Like Jesus is saying these words for all of us today, come to me because you will find rest in my heart. Sometimes we feel confused, nervous, sad, miserable, disappointed when we lose someone who is very, very precious in our hearts. Like today, we are saying goodbye to our brother Bill, and we are in sorrowful moments. But if we come to Jesus and say to him today, we need your help, we need your strength, we need you to support us, to give us your hand to continue the road with you. Because we believe in your words that Bill today will be with you in paradise. Because you said to us, everyone between you, even if he died, but he believed in me, he will receive the eternal life. This is our faith, this is our hope, and this is our love for our beloved brother, Bill. Bill was a wonderful person in the community. I didn't know him in person, but when the family called me last week to give him the last rites, I knew him in seconds, like this. When I looked to his face, I told Cindy he was a good spirit, a lovely person. She told me yes. And this is a fact, because when the priest pray from all his heart to a person, he will have a spiritual link with him. My relation with Bill, it's not in person, it's spiritual. Because I started with this man with a prayer when I gave him the last rites. And thank God that I was ready on the road when they called me. In 5 minutes I was in the house to bless him, because I felt something that I must give him the last rites now. I must give him the gift now. And the second day he passed. But he received the best gift from the church that will open for him the gates of heaven. And this is the faith of his family. This is the faith of his wife, his son, and his two daughters. Because they were praying with me at the house to make the soul of Bill more comforted, more comforted, more relaxed. And I knew about Bill during his life from 1950 till 2021, that I will call him, and permit for me, I will call him the Good Samaritan. Because he was helping a lot without show off. He was a quiet man, calm man, respectful man. He helped a lot without show off. One of the parishioners told me a story about Bill. One day he was on the road near the farms, and suddenly he had an accident on the road. And guess who? God who sent for him, this man, Bill Koury. He spent with him 1 hour to fix the car and to stay with him and to make sure that this man will be safe, and then he came back home. These are the secrets of Bill. No one knows them. Even his family maybe doesn't know them. But we know them because we have now a spiritual link between this man and us. I will say, yes, we are in a sorrow. We are crying. We are disappointed because we need him more on this earth. But God picked the best flower from his garden to put it in the heaven and in the kingdom. So don't be sad. Cry with faith. Cry and pray. Be sad, but be in joy, because your Father today will be in heaven with Jesus Christ. God bless you all, and we will keep praying for him. All of us, like a community, like a friend, like a church that loved Bill so much. And I will conclude to say that on my behalf and the behalf of the deacons, we offer our sincere condolences to his wife, to his son Philip, and to his two daughters and sons-in-law, and the sisters and the grandsons and daughters, and the friends. God bless you all, and we promise that we will keep praying for this wonderful man, and we love you so much. I want you to remember that we need you in the church, and we love you so much, to honor Bill in every prayer we will offer for him in this wonderful church, St. Louis Gonzaga. God bless you, and thank you so much. Something like a sign from God. This is the last in Shihotkom min Beit Miti Itraham Alain, because after tomorrow we will begin to say Itraham Alain. What's the meaning of Mshihotkom? God, the Christ who was risen from the dead, have mercy on us. And it's a sign that Bill will be risen with God today in the paradise. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon him.
May he rest in peace.
Amen.
May his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen. Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray, one Our Father and one Hail Mary for the soul of our departed brother, Bill Koury. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
O Lord God of limitless mercy and boundless generosity, by the power of your cross and your holy resurrection, Have mercy on our brother Bill, for whom we gathered here today.
Amen.
May he rest in peace with the company of the saints in the eternal life.
Amen.
And live among them and with them, raise glory and thanks.
Amen.
To you and to your Father and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Christ is risen.
Truly is he risen. Is risen.
May his soul rest in peace in the heavenly kingdom. Now, greeting to the family. You can shake hands, don't worry. Cynthia.